Hello, it's George Lees again. I'm going to start off where we left off on the quest to find out who the hell is Hannah Mary Brookfield's husband. Yeah, his name is William Brookfield, and we had found his business interest. I want to take you closer to home. I'm now going back into the revelation that the Brookdales and the Brookfields are related to the Morgans, and the Morgans are massive fraudsters, and they are out of Wales. They now have sold their massive mansions to the National Trust, like the Rothschilds have done. Yeah, but the whole of the bloodline is extinct, if you believe that. So, the rat is out of the cage and the kitchen in the bloodline that we showed you for the Rothschilds earlier on, and that is one of the religious battle scenes, or it's one of my favourite places in the world, where my brother-in-law lived, and we used to spend all of our holidays and Easter breaks and Christmas breaks and when we returned. So that's a town called Upper Swell, and just above that you have a tiny little village called Stow on the Wold, and that is where the Christian battles were fought in the massive revolutionary wars that were carried out on behalf of Charles I and Charles II. Yeah, I'm going to now show you the execution of Charles I. Yeah, it's tragic. Yeah, the whole of the world is torn apart by the really clever people all across Europe that are the elite owners of the world. Yeah, and most of them are from the Bavarian Austrian master races, like Jacob Rothschild, in which we showed you in the last video. Okay, so let me now show you the trial and execution. It will take 6 or 7 minutes, but it is quite pathetic, and YouTube are now so sensitive that they've shut down my own Facebook page, my own YouTube channel. Yeah, I cannot show my own videos on this computer now. Yeah, because these are heretical issues. This is the execution of the king by the parliamentarians that are a cabal of power brokers. And it's the same today. They're totally unelected. Every one of them is picked for their power base and their capacity to be manipulated and to be coerced into the wrong decisions every time. Okay, so this is boring, but it is typifies. Yeah, I've been prone to showing you, for my romanticism, the executions of the Protestant and the Catholic queens and all the contenders, but this is the reigning monarch in a mature age, and he's a happy family man. Yeah, and you can see that the top of his knob falls off. And he's got that massive Jewish nose, and I've shown you in the video with the Zadok the Priest music on it how all of the kingdom is likely to be run by Jewish people through all of its time. Yeah, and that is the migration of the tribes, and that is why Connie Nielsen from Denmark is happily married for a time, only 2 years, to Nathan Rothschild Jr. Okay, just watch the knob, it's faster than the speed of light. Yeah, and the circumcision and all of it is just divisive protocols to get Christians killing Jews, and Christians and Jews killing Muslims and the Islamic faith, all of them launched by the same fraudsters called the Pisos. Yeah, 800 years apart. Yeah, and that is the Pi Pi Piso Pilgrims, and it's all through the story.
The court commands the charge be read.
My lord, in behalf of the Commons of England and of all the people thereof,
under this,
and the lyrics are in Spanish, and that is the Spanish launch of the massive Inquisition and the killing of millions of gullible people that follow these religious leadership teams. Yeah? Does not matter what gender you are, if you're at the top of the food chain, yeah, and you're not in those inner circle families, like the Queen still is in Britain, yeah, you are in a very dangerous place. Okay, the gods will not tolerate it much longer if the things that are happening around me continue to happen.
In behalf of the Commons of England and of all the people thereof, I do accuse Charles Stuart, here present, as a tyrant, traitor, and murderer, public and implacable enemy to the Commonwealth of England and man of blood.
So that, believe it or not, was King Charles giggling, and if you look at his shoulder, you'll see that he has the same icon on his shoulder that every British copper, every British king, every British knight of Malta, and all of the European knights of Malta have on their shoulder. It is a massive mafia operation. You can just see it glinting there. Watch carefully. Yeah, it's John Patterson who pointed this out to me. Yeah, and the Asia blue bands, the birds keep knocking on my windows, I don't know why. Okay, and that's the Asia blue band for the Austrian master races.
The Commonwealth of England.
Every cop on our streets, that giggle is not mine.
Sir, you would have your answer. I would never want you for authority. I'm called Emperor. Remember, I am your king.
We are satisfied of our own authority.
It is not your self-satisfaction which should decide the matter. I know as much law as any one of you. Show me one precedent in history for these proceedings.
It is not for a prisoner to require.
Sir, I am not an ordinary prisoner.
In the name of the people of England.
The prisoner, having refused to give his answer to the charges, has thereby confessed his guilt. The prisoner may speak. I must tell you all. This many a day, all things have been taken away from me. But that which I call more dear to me than my life, my conscience and my honour. I have more respect to my life than the peace of the kingdom. I should have made a defence for myself that might leastwise have delayed the ugly sentence which I believe you will pass on me. I know it is in vain to dispute with you. I cannot deny the power you have. I have nothing more to say.
Do you see the Phrygian hats that the politicians wear?
Sir.
The joke about Austro-Hungaria and the launch of all of the conflicts, the Phrygian hat from the Aegean.
There is a bond made between a king and...
Oh, sorry. Let's move it on a bit. And let's get to the family scenes. Here we go.
Sweetheart, I fear you will forget this.
I shall not forget, father.
That's his daughter.
Child,
this son.
They will cut off my head. And perhaps make you a king. But mark what I see. You must not be a king so long as your brothers do live.
I'll be torn in pieces first.
And the jester's hat, just like Notre Dame and the Hunchback movie. Yeah, just like the government and the monarchy today. There's no need for a monarchy anywhere. It's a massive breach of human rights. There's the head now. Dripping. Can you hear it dripping? And that is the Austrian flag with the belt that prevented the blood getting onto their bloody red vestments. Right then, so let's take you through
1661.
So there you can see that 61. I've got a privacy reminder that I've got to let's get rid of that. Okay, and show you the pictures. Okay, so this is the Chipping Norton Sets hub. It is the religious wars crime scene for the beautiful place that is in the next image. And that is right above this lower swell where my brother-in-law lived. Yeah, and there's a place called May on the top of the hill before you get to Stow-on-the-Wold. And that is the naming of one of the Magic Circle law firms. It's May and something else. Okay? And there's the churches, and when we went to the churches with my brother-in-law and my disloyal wife, they showed us, yeah, the mother-in-law of the poofy brother, the poofy civil husband of my brother-in-law, he is called Georgiou, and they're from the Aegean region, and they are actually likely to be from Macedonia, because this is the religious fraud. And when we went to church on the last occasion, yeah, when that year when we had the massive snowstorms, when I came back in the Christmas of 2009, yeah, as a professor, yeah, with all of the insight into how the brain works, yeah, I could not get a job beyond that, and I got scammed out of all the jobs that I got, yeah, and all of the members of the pharmacy profession that did that. I don't know how they live with themselves. I'm a fellow of that profession. I'm a professor of drug safety. Yeah, that is a woman called Fryer in the pharmacy in Edinburgh at Strayton. Yeah, and it is the vicar that has the horrible cancer that got me scammed out of my job in Kelso, sent me to Peebles where the Tweedsmuirs launched the wars from. Okay, I'm naming all of the names now. I want them to have a conscience. Yeah, this is Stow-on-the-Wold, and when we went to the church, my wife and her brother and his husband, yeah, the male husband from Macedonia, he pointed out that all of the Arsenal people were sitting in front of us, black men, looking a little bit like the Egyptian pharaoh bloodlines that are the Arsenals. Yeah, and that's the massive religious fraud, and Arsene Wenger is the manager of Arsenal still. That's the Arsenals that were the pharaohs all the way up to Cleopatra. And they think they're really clever because they learn that. And all of the churches are built on stilts, and that is the joke about hell being underneath. And they need it being built on stilts because it's Morton on the Marsh, and that is what the gods do when they get replaced by Jesus Christ the fraud. Let's keep going, because we're in the political world again now. Chipping Norton Mill, yeah, the penis structure on everything. It's got the top locked off too, yeah, isn't that funny? Yeah, and this is where Ronnie Barker ran his antique shop. Yeah, that's Ronnie Barker of the two Ronnies. That is Ronnie Barker, who's a mate of Balfour Corbett, and you'll see him on the next slide. That's the buffoon that is Jeremy Clarkson. That is the buffoon that is David Cameron, now resigned with a new 16 million mansion, yeah, as they leave my wife to tear me apart, yeah, as part of his and HRH's intel op. Okay, there's Rebecca Brooks, the liar, yeah, and the propagandist for Murdoch, and the Murdochs, they are there, and they are married to the Freud psychiatrists, and Snowy Cameron is the prostitute for King Charles that you've just seen, and she is the sire of one of the kids, and she, the rival sire, is a Catholic, of course, so that they can divide and conquer in everything that they do, and she is a Kersdale, and the people at the bottom are the Vodafone magnates and the massive business hub that this is for the unelected people that drink in a club. Charlie and Rebecca Brooks, David and Samantha Cameron, Matthew and Elizabeth Freud. She's the one that interlocks with Police Superintendent Gormley, who's now the head of the United Force in Scotland. And there they all are, in behind closed doors, doing what they do best, stealing from the country and stealing from the charities. These are the Red Nose Day fraudsters too. Yeah, they are the Do They Know It's Christmas fraudsters, and all of them get what they deserve in the end, which is why that could be the baby that died. Yeah, Ivan, the Ivanhoe joke. Right then, so this is JP Morgan. This is the man that we touched on. Guess what his real name is behind that initial? It's Jean, as in all of those Freemasonic stories we've told you, and Long John Silver, yeah, getting the treasure at the end and knowing where the treasure map is. And he's a liar, which is why he gets the Pinocchio nose. Yeah, it's quite astounding when you see it in colour, but they will not show you it in colour for obvious reasons. And the P is for St. Peter who never lived. That's John Pierpoint Morgan. That is the joke about Naples and the pier in Brighton, and every pier is St. Peter, the joke. Yeah, and it's the spinning top, the peary is the spinning top every Christmas in the presents that you get, and they get confused with the dreidel for the Jewish faith, and all of it is just a profit stream and a way of killing the people for centuries. Okay, a man always has two reasons for doing anything, a good reason and the real reason. And next you will see that that is why he gets the big nose. Yeah, J. Pierpoint Morgan. And he's the one that was in charge of the regime as Teddy Roosevelt took over from the murdered president who was McKinley. Yeah, killed in the ITU. Okay, so what else can we show you? So the place that you've just seen in near Chipping Norton, which is that lovely stone in the wall, was a religious battlefield. I'll show you the statistics on how many died. And that, for some reason, is an Alf Garnett lookalike in the midst of all of those people that are just J.P. Morgan and the Morgans that we tell you about that link you to the Pirates of the Caribbean are vicars in the Episcopalian faith with the word piso in it. Right then. So, where next? There we've got the wreck of the Titan. So this guy escaped sinking of the Titanic. He was one of 7 or 8 passengers who withdrew really fortunately from that. And if we went there and we went back a couple of pages, we would see... So this one, I believe, is the Titanic passengers. Okay? It claimed 1,500 lives, and the Astors were on board, I think. The Guggenheims both went down with the ship, as did Macy's, his wife Ida. Yeah, so some of them get killed by their mates in the elites, and some of them survive it, and they make massive jokes about it. And that's my biggest hero in Hollywood, is the woman that is the... in the Right Stuff movie, and she's a local actress here, or she's a body double for her. Okay, so quickly, Dreiser is one. Marconi, who invented the telephone, he's a dead ringer for the Camerons in my town. Don't know if that's anything to do with the bloodline. Okay, and when you look at Marconi, it can be twisted to Cameron. Yeah, and all of it is absolutely spooky. When you look at that man, it's just like looking at the man that is married to the Swedish wife, and that's a very decent person. Okay, even although they are named Cameron. Yeah, the Italian inventor of the wireless was on the offered free passage on the Titanic, and so they used his method to tell what had happened. Yeah, when it was sunk. Yeah, and there is the Hershey's, that are the sweetie people, the Hershey bars, and that is the Barbara Hershey's, and the links to Helen Hirsch in Rothschild, and Nazi bloodlines. Yeah, that's the joke about Ralph Fiennes and the Hershey's. Yeah, so they're lucky. Yeah. And all of that becomes the sweetie mafias that we've told you about. And all of the plots to kill the people by all sorts of methods. There he is with the big nose. Jesus, pie, Pierpoint, male organ. Do you get it? Yeah, so his name is J.P. Morgan, and that's the male organ. And it's quite obvious to you that that is the fish on a Friday for the Catholics. Don't know whether or not he's a Catholic or Protestant, does not bother with it. The legendary 74-year-old financier, nicknamed the Napoleon of Wall Street, helped create General Electric and U.S. Steel with Carnegie. Single-handedly, he was the savior of the U.S. banking system during the Great Depression and the 1907 period. Yeah, and all of that is the lead-up to Woodrow Wilson's massive warmongering scam. Among his various businesses, he was an international mercantile marine. The ships combined controlled Britain's white owners of the Titanic. So he's the profiteer from the Titanic. Yeah, and it's all part of the propaganda that this is what we're going to do. And they wrote a novel called The Sinking of the Titan exactly 10 years before they did what they did to the Titanic. Yeah, Morgan attended the ship's launching, personal suite on board. Yeah, but he did not go because he knows what they're going to do. Yeah, and that's why he's the liar. Oh, and why did we not see the... with the images... Oh yeah, we've got more images. Did J.P. Morgan build the Titanic to kill off the competition? Yeah, so the Astors get topped on it. Yeah, and... it's amazing. And the Duchess of Roxburgh launched the Mauritania, and all of it is just a massive set of fascist tools to get rid of the ordinary people. But the people that are on those ships are their deserted friends. Right then, quickly. There was something else that I was going to show you that I've not seen. Did we see Ronnie Barker and his shops? Oh, and this is the Rothschild News of yesterday's video. Yeah, they keep pretending that they're innocent and everybody's anti-Semitic against them. So there's the first person that was married to them, or was their lovers, yeah, that was a Gentile. Yeah, that's Julie Rothschild and Fitzroy. Yeah, that's the story that we've got in the film about the Rothschilds. There is no one who fits that profile or that profile. Yeah, then we get another pair. That is Lady Hannah Mayer Amschel Fitzroy, born Rothschild, on the left. And that presumably is Lord Mayer Amschel Rothschild on the right. Yeah, they were married in 1834. And they are the people that are portrayed. Yeah, when you look up Fitzroy and his marriage to Hannah Rothschild, that's what you find. Okay, and this one, it's claimed in Wikipedia for years and years and years, is plump Hannah Rothschild, who married, I think, out of one of the other mansions, and that is Archie Rosebery, the pouf célèbre. Yeah, that was the Prime Minister, and his pink race horsey jockey's gear was used for the Scottish football team. After I came back from New Zealand, as a piss take that all of these are the world owners and we will do anything we like with the world and we will not have any decency or open-ended political activity anywhere on our globe. That's our globe, even although we sink our friends with the ships that we build and profit from. Okay, so the red indicates the first Gentile to marry Rothschild. 1, 2, 3 claims. Yeah, and these are all the propagandists that work for them now. They are the Governor Generals. They get six-figure salaries, $300,000 a year, to be a political plant with no commitments other than to the empire upon which the sun will set. And it gets in behind the shadow of her tits. Yeah, that is the Fergie jokes. And she's actually, her nickname was not Fergie at all. I made a mistake. Her nickname was Jordan, and that is the Scottish football player too. And there's Fergie, that is the cover for the Twin Towers and all of the things that happen when religion and the sectarian violence is released systematically from by them. And there's the poor god Thor that they pinched the hammer from in the legend. Yeah, and that's the boomerang that will not come back. Yeah, and that is the replacement and displacement of the gods with the human messiahs. Yeah, totally written out of the Bible and all of the texts now. Token mention in a hymn occasionally. Yeah. And there is the biggest fraud in recent times, because that is Mr. Bean. That is the man who's played by Rowan Atkinson at the London Olympics. And he is playing the human organ, yeah, in front of all of those spectators. Yeah, with the Apollo, yeah, twisted rings being the female vagina. Yeah, and that is Jim Reeves and the propagandists for all of the Rothschilds not making more than £1 million in the Napoleonic Wars. Yeah, and it's massive. And that is the killing of every Anzac troop at Gallipoli, because he, Mr. Bean, was the war correspondent for Gallipoli, and his equivalent, he is a Ferguson like that one. Is a diversion like all of the Busby Babes jokes, and he is the High Commissioner for New Zealand and now Bermuda and the tax havens, and all around the world we are corrupted. Right, so let me take you back to, so do you get it, the Titanic people? And let me just quickly take you down through the Titanic listings. Oh no, I can't be bothered with that, it's too complicated. You see how many hits I've got on my website, yeah. And that is still linked under a Rothschild tab. So this is Let me now get on with the story about telling you about Hannah Mary Rothschild's husband, who's so evasive, it's incredible. So let's get back to where we were with him and looking for the Brookfield, and that's the Hershey Chocolatiers, and that is the all the films that they make in Hollywood about the chocolatiers. Yeah, do you get it? That is all of the treason in wartime and all of the jokes about what these families do and how their bloodlines interconnect to all of the presidential bloodlines and to the Mayflower passengers and to the little James, the earlier king that was James the First and James the Sixth of England, and the King James Bible for genocide. So that one is where we left off. Okay, do you recognise it? Brookfield Companies. Yeah, it's taken me ages to find out who this man is. I cannot find a picture of him at all. Okay, that is one of the most powerful of them. The Brookfield Asset Management, I believe that they have interlocks to Lord Kerif Kinlocker and the massive scams that are his interests in Royal Dutch Shell and many other massive companies, including Rio Tinto and the Queen's babies like that. Yeah, the Queen does not appear on the boards now, for shame. Okay, so this is where we left off. Brookfield Renewable Power, yeah, the wind powers. And yet in the earlier video, episode one of this one, I've shown you that the wind power is the blades of the windmill. Yet there are four of them in the early Dutch windmills. Yet they are the giants in the legends about Don Quixote and the knight looking for something to fight just for the hell of it. Yeah, the romantic thing that kills every pagan on our world. Yeah, and the windmill is actually the swastika for the global Freemasons through all of Freemasonic history. Yeah, that is the there once was a windmill in old Amsterdam, and all of the Irish Freemasons jokes, Val Dunican now dead, yeah, about Delaney's donkey and all of the Mayflower passengers that are the FDR families and Teddy's families. Brookfield Infrastructure Partners Limited, Brookfield Multiplex Limited, Brookfield Country Club, Brookfield Financial Properties LP, Real Estate, Australian based private golf club in Clarence, New York, where we finished off. And that is the angel that comes down in my favourite movie about financial services and building affordable homes for all of the poor citizens, yeah, of Pottersville when it turns bad, yeah, Bedford Falls in the happy ending. Yeah, don't know whether or not I'm going to get a happy ending here. I'm quite happy working under the hands of the gods and getting their guidance. Brookfield Financial Properties LP, Brookfield Global Timber Fund. Okay, Brookfield's Global Timber Fund acquired a 77% interest of Longview Timber. Do you get that one in the joke about the spears? Yeah, that's the spears that are the architects for the Rothschilds and the spears that are the SS for Hitler Rothschild. Yeah, and they get into the Braveheart film because their spears are long enough yet to bring down a piezo horse, and on and on and on it goes. Brookfield Energy Marketing distributes hydroelectric power once they build the dams, like they did in the Nile and they did in Butcher Jones Park in America. Yeah, that is the FDR dams in the Fugitive movies, and for them it is a huge piss take that the gods cannot flood the world near the evil people when they want to. Brookfield Infrastructure LP, Brookfield Brazil Timber Fund, yeah, that is all of the South American rainforests, yeah, that were massive, that were all over the Amazonian joke, and that is the German filmmakers making the films about Fitzcarraldo and the opera singers, yeah, the piss artists that come in and become the financial magnates that ruin the ecology of the countries and then launch global warming as another money stream, using the religious joke to launch El Nino, the weather storms, because El Nino was the baby Jesus when they first sailed with the three ships on Christmas Day in the morning for Magellan in the South Pacific. It is absolutely evil. Brookfield Zoo, so they can have the Piso Menagerie. Yeah, and the Turkish Fez, and that's why we've got a panda in Edinburgh that replaced the massive gorilla that was me. Yeah, and the panda is the icon for the fascists' World Wildlife Fund, and that is Prince Philip and King Bernhard of the Netherlands, the massive fascists whose children cannot see because they have the little red affliction. Okay, Brookfield Renewable Power Fund, Brookfield Multiplex Constructions Private Something Limited, the large Australian one, a global advisory board on infrastructure, Brookfield Renewable Energy Partners LP, Brookfield Infrastructure Partners LP, Brookfield Office Properties. Okay, so you can spend hours looking through the massive amounts of land that they hold, or at their directors, and there are many famous people there. Yeah, but Brookfield himself is not on the boards, he's not in any of the pictures, he's not in any of their corporate documents, and he's the world's biggest secret because he's married to the British aristocracy that is still the Emperor of Austria, according to the title that he was given in 1992, Jacob Rothschild, Hannah Mary's dad. Yeah, that is Hannah Mary Brookfield, with all of these directorates. She's only got one company now, and that is RIT, which is, she's joined on by the Duke of Wellington. Right then, so let's get moving, and let's tell you the rest of the vicious story that means that all of the religious massacres take place in Chipping Norton for David Cameron, just to round it off nicely with Rivers of Blood. Okay, Brookfield. So this is how I found the links. And I'm just going to have to close that thing on the right. So this is now Debrett's. I showed you in video number one how all sorts of families, including the people that are the wife of the stammering king in the movie, she is Bonham Carter. Yeah, she's in the bloodlines that link to Hannah Mary Rothschild and to Jacob, and to link and the Patterson with one T. I just saw him go by, and the body double in my town for Nathan Rothschild has declared that the Patterson with one T is his father. Or it could be his uncle, and when I looked him in the eye and waved at him at his wife waved back and he cast his head in the opposite direction, right down into the gutter. He's the one that is the close relative of Natty Rothschild, Hannah's brother, who drinks in the pubs here with John Lamont. That's John de Lamont on the Pilgrim Fathers. Okay, Brookfield and other verse. So this is Debrett's entries. You've got one there from Marshall William and William Edward, 1859 to 1923, Mrs. Brookfield and her circle. And then you've got a series of more interesting middle names and Christian names. So Brookfield Charles H.E., Charles Hallam Elton, 1857 to 1913, Brookfield Francis M, Mrs. C.H.E. Brookfield. Yeah, so all of those I will be able to look up. There is not one picture of Hannah's husband, there is not one picture of their wedding, not one picture of their honeymoon. 12 generations in America. Yeah, so text and topics: Brookfield William Henry, 1809 to 1874, Brookfield Jane Octavia, 1821 to 1896. This is the clue that they're the Morgans. 12 generations in America, being the lineage of William Lord Brookfield, Henry Morgan Brookfield, yeah, Samuel Lord Brookfield, sons of Henry Morgan Brookfield and Louise Lord. Yeah, and that is the Lord name that sometimes appears. Yeah, if you look at the Wikipedia profile for him and Hannah being married, he is William Lord Brookfield. So we're on the trail at last. Not one image, even on Debrett's. And thank you to my old boss in pharma for asking me how I'm doing. Yeah, I will not demean myself by asking any of them to pay my disloyal wife, yeah, for half of the house that she does not deserve. She deserves everything that she gets from God in the future, yeah, and I'm looking for a moral result there, okay? 12 generations in America, being a lineage of William Lord Brookdale, Henry Morgan Brookfield Jr., Samuel Lord Brookfield, sons of Henry Morgan Brookfield and Louise Lord. Okay, do you get it? That is them. Yeah, and the brands that are in the Brookfield family tree, yeah, are on the same pages as Hannah Mary Rothschild's pages. Yeah, that's the brands and the joke about my wife getting her future read by the man called Brand in England. With the long hair, a little bit like Charles II, hopeless comedian. Okay, title also known as Brookfield Lineage, Statement of Responsibility by Henry Morgan Brookfield. Yeah, and there he is, the main author, Henry Morgan, born 1871, and Cook, Lewis Daniel, added author. The pedigree, and that's the same statement again, there's very little data on them, but they're in New York, they're right next to Staten Island, and they're yeah, right like the Protestant island. That's the Protestant island that is the joke about Glasgow Rangers, that we are the people. I forget what the joke is, it's so long since I made the video. Yeah, and that becomes the village people that sing about the YMCA on the other side of the country. Yeah, right next door to Pearl Harbor's launch point, which is the birds that used to eat the oysters, oyster catchers. And that's Oyster Bay for the two different massive mansions for Teddy Roosevelt and his brother. Yeah, and all the wars that they cause and all the sectarian violence. Okay, so do you get the brand linkage to the family trees that I've shown you already? Okay, and Morgan is new, that is the only thing that we can search as a term in the future search. Okay, now we've got the links and the surnames that come out: Avery, Avers, Barber. And there's yeah, it's ever so twisted, but everything with the B and the Bears, yeah, everything is a Rothschild derivation. Brandreth, Morgan and Platt, that's Edith Piaf, yeah, and all the jokes about the pie, yeah, it's the same joke all the way through. Pie, A, two crosses. Okay, film notes. So this is the Debrett's entry. There is no logical story telling you about, but you have to pay a subscription to get onto this. Okay? And what you're searching is the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. Yeah. All of the saints are launched as jokes by these ruthless, murderous families. Santa Cruz is the Sant Crucifix. Yeah, right then. So this is the one that took me into the links to Wales. Yeah, and this is the vicar. Okay, Henry Morgan Brookfield, 1911 to 1991. The bloodline is, according to them, extinct. Okay, family tree and genealogy tools. Henry Morgan Brookfield, born April 11th, 1911 in New York City. Husband of Elizabeth Scott Bradley Brookfield, Yeah, I presume that is her maiden name. Married June the 2nd, 1939. Location unknown. Yeah, I think that is the year that the Titanic was sunk, just to make sure that the war happens and everybody gets riled up. Okay. January 29th, 1991, in Nyack, Rockland, New York. And when he comments on the Titanic, he just tells about the important thing is the deaths and all of those huge numbers of deaths. End of story. Turns his back on it. That's why his nose is so massive. Yeah, and that is why Pinocchio's nose get massive. And Pinocchio has a tail and he has bunny ears. And all of it is the same joke as Jumanji. And all of it is the same joke as the conscripting of the troops. So they become the jackasses with the tail sticking out of the uniforms. And it's ever so funny if you're a know-nothing, or you're an American president, or you're a Brookfield that's not allowed to identify themselves. Henry Morgan Brookfield Jr., a former administrator of Grace Episcopalian Church in Nyack, died Tuesday at Nyack Hospital after a brief illness. He was 79. Mr. Brookfield was born in New York City on April 11th, 1911, to Henry Morgan and Minnie Louise Lord Brookfield. You get it? The Lord in the middle. I thought he was a member of the peerage already, but he has no entry, as far as I can see, on Burke's peerage. You just keep getting references to references. Yeah, and none of his genealogy. But the only thing that we can see there is that family that is, that has come through in yesterday's story and today's. He married Elizabeth Scott Bradley on June 2nd, 1939. He is survived by his wife, four children, H. Morgan Brookfield III of Memphis, Tennessee, Elizabeth B. Perry, yeah, that's the Perrys of Michael Ancrum's constituency. It's Katie Perry with the initials KP, but this one is much more innocent because she's Elizabeth B. Perry. Yeah. Richard B. Brookfield and Louise Lord Ordstadt, both of Marietta. Is that Galway? G.A. And 14 grandchildren. A memorial service is scheduled. Okay. Grace Episcopalian Church. The most decent woman and cleric I know is called Grace. She's at the Episcopalian Church. And I don't know whether or not that is part of the reading the future, but she is a lovely person. Yeah, and her husband is a nice guy too, and they talk openly and decently. They do not threaten or tell you that you're going to be bankrupted by them in the next few days, like all of the politicians at the council level and at the parliamentary level, in the Scottish traitors group at Holyrood and in the English traitors group, yeah, all across Rothschild England. Yeah, that's Hannah Mary's own persecution of me. Right then, so I think, so the DNA, I don't know what their consanguinity index is yet, and I've not looked it up. I'll look it up tonight, promise you. So here's Morgan, and this is Vicious. This is the launch of the pirates. It's the launch of the National Trust looking after all of these filthy billionaires. It's the launch of the 30 years religious war all across Europe and all across Britain. You have two religious revolutions to contend with in the same period. Yet that man got his head lopped off for, and you saw the blood dripping down onto the, yeah, the boards, like the Rothschild shield. Yeah, red in World War II, and then when Israel gets partitioned, it becomes the blue shield. Yeah, and everything, and all of the genocides, Christian and Jew, and all of the people in Austro-Hungary that are Islamic. Yeah, and all of those that are Moorish, and all of those that are Indian religions, all of them are dead in the ditches, and there is Tredegar House in Wales. Yeah, as the name would suggest. These are Morgan pirates and religious warlords, Caribbean to Holy Flanders. Yeah, it's as sick as that. That's the religious wars in 1620 to 1650 that are conducted in Flanders Field, where the poppies come from, for the Popo dynasty that is Queen Elizabeth II and sells the fucking poppies to the poor and the relatives of the fucking dead. Main entrance to Tredegar House. Now with the National Trust, with every one of those Rothschilds, okay, it's a Carolingian institution, and it is in the region of Monmouthshire, where my mate Dr. Paul Shazza, who's had his innards taken out, yeah, he's the profiteer from Frankish, the east side of France, from Lyon, yeah, and his sister lives in Monmouthshire on top of the cliffs. Yeah, I can't imagine the cliffs around the Cardiff area where that is, but she told me when I met her that they had cliffs. Okay, so it is, the client is, so this is Tredegar House, and it was William Morgan of Machen and Tredegar, and the management is the National Trust now. Yeah, completed in 1672, 2 years after the 30 Years' War has ka-chinged for them. Rape and pillage all across every country in Europe, and the Pilgrim Fathers are already through millions and millions of the American 500 nations. Absolutely sickening. In the same period, you have two religious wars in the Chipping Norton Setts region, even. Yeah, and that is the joke about Hungerford and the massive massacres there. Okay, let's get it finished, just in case. Yeah, I'm very loud and outspoken. Yeah, Tredegar House, 17th century, Charles II era country house mansion in Cuaid Cernu, at the western edge of the city of Newport. Yeah, the river that runs through it is the Usk, and that is the Christian cross. In front of the Usk is the new power broker in Parliament, Tusk. Yeah, the person that is in all the Brexit debates and all the power base, I forget which party he's in, everything. That's how trivial the world is. When I'm coming at it, they know I'm coming at it. All of the obfuscation tools are launched. Never heard of Tusk until 2016. Yeah? Do you now see why we've got it? And that is the Mersey jokes. Yeah, that is Mary's arse. And on it goes. Okay, so there is Tredegar House, right in the Bristol Channel. And remember that that is a unique place. The gods give them a storm coming up that, the tidal wave comes up that estuary every day of the week, I think, as far as I'm aware. Yeah, and it's amazing. The gods are absolutely superb, and their timing and their justice is perfect. Okay, and right up here, up at the top of the map, you've got, oh no, I posted that before I put it in. So Hay on Wye is a little bit further up, and that is where Hannah Mary Rothschild issues the propaganda for the book festival. Yeah, she's no longer left on the business registers because I've totally shamed her. Poor woman. Yeah, they don't need new businesses. They've got so much money that they cannot spend it in their lifetimes. Yeah, they've got the whole world and all its financial institutions and all of its intel and law enforcement and all of its judiciary. Yeah, and there's the Pembrokeshire coast where the Welsh pilgrims came from. And Merthyr Tydfil, I think that has been some pit accidents. You get the word pie, P-I-T. Yeah, fascist black. All of it for profit. All of it for massacres when they need them. Yeah, and that happened in New Zealand immediately after I left. British owned mine. Okay, Biddeford. Yeah, the Bedford Falls jokes. Yeah, and it's the same at Stratford-on-Avon. That's the Stepping Stones Ford. Yeah, and that is where the MP for Stratford-on-Avon is a war criminal from Iraq. Yeah, Zahawi. Body double in Sainsbury's supermarket works like a slave. Okay, so the river runs through it is the Usk, and the launch of Tusk into politics less than 6 months ago near the book festival in Hay. Yeah, that's what it means. For over 500 years it was the home to the Morgan family. But we'd better make sure that we started at the top of the page, because I'm very prone to... Oh, I think we did. Yeah, we did. It's red brick. Did you see it in the picture, like all of the Liverpool institutions? For over 500 years, it was the home to the Morgans, later Lords Tredegar, one of the most powerful and influential families in the area, described as the grandest and most exuberant country house in Monmouthshire and one of the outstanding houses of the Restoration period in the whole of Britain. The mansion stands in a reduced landscape garden of 90 acres, yeah, forming the non-residential part of Tredegar Park. The property became a Grade 1 listed building. Yeah, massive work of art for the fascists on the 3rd of March 1952, and has been under the care of the National Trust since March 2012. Which is why the Hancocks are members of the National Trust. Because they are slaves to these people, and they could well be the founders of Rio Tinto with Lang Hancock without the S. The Tredegar Morgans, 1402 to 1951, extinct, one hopes. Yeah, when you see the battles and the bloodletting that happens. Yeah, that's that tiny little tab there. I should go to that and show you. Oh no, let's just do it. Let's see whether it is that one. I'll show you the images first. Okay, so open this. Bloodletting UK in Naseby, Northampton. Yeah, that's where I've told you about all of the death camps and the training camps for the double agents way back in the Napoleonic Wars. Yeah, and these are the wars that are way back beyond that, and that is the French people coming across to help Charlie Stuart and all those Stuart rebellions, yeah, Catholic versus Protestant, yeah, and across the border, and with the French aid, the first of the two religious revolutions in the UK, yeah, United Kingdom, that's exclamation mark, it is not united, it is totally divided by design, and all of the intel organisations work so that none of it can be rational or logical and beneficial to anybody in our country except the monarchs, yeah, and the money lenders that Jesus warned us about. Same time as Christians are fighting Christians all over Europe, and the king gets executed, and his son Charles II is the great great grandpa of Fitzroy, who marries the Rothschilds. Yeah, that's the one in the middle of that graph I showed you. As a Gentile and Charles II, he befriends the pineapple growers. Look at the towns where the battles were fought. Fairfax buried in Naples. Yeah, that's my mate Fairfax, Lady Fairfax, who's a friend of Abel Danger. Yeah, and I believe it is the woman that is Naomi Klein, and I met her in the pub. Yeah, and she is an absolute bimbo, and they are an absolute abomination. That's Naomi Klein, the false socialist that wrote about George W. Bush and all of the brutalisation of Iraq and all of the tsunami places, and her next task is to convince the world that global warming is true and that El Nino was never the baby Jesus, but is the global warming things that are because of the evil behaviours of the poor 9 billion people on this earth. It's a crock of lies, and the gods know it, and they are now in a really dangerous place. So Fairfax was buried in Naples, and that's where Archie Rosebery spent his life with Plumpana, who died at 40 with the word Piso in the blood cancer that she got. Cemetery and Morgan out of the National Trust. Okay, so the words of where the battles took place, and it is tragic. Okay, so there is Naseby mentioned. Let me read it off. This is the first of two civil wars in England. Yet one battle, 1,000 killed at Naseby and 5,000 captured. That's Northampton at Corby, and that's the launch of Corbyn. Yet as the cover for the political party when they chucked the guys from Lithuania out of the Labour Party. Yeah, I chased the first one out because he's a banking mobster and was the MP for Newcastle. First Hull, Portsmouth, Powick Bridge, Edge Hill, Aylesbury, where we lived and I played my rugby, Brentford, Chichester, Turnham Green, Braddock Down, Leeds, First Middlewich, Hopton Heath, the rabbit joke for Winston. Yeah? Seacroft Moor, Camp Hill, Reading, yeah, where I've been, and all of those frauds about the financial frauds and the neuroscience department running massive Ponzi schemes that report directly to the Pritchards of Tring that were in our birthing chamber, which was a Rothschild mansion and is now RAF Halton. Yeah, that's Heather Pritchard was on that Ponzi scheme for UK PLC or whatever it was called. Okay, Stratton, Wakefield, Chalgrove Field, Adwalton Moor, Burton Bridge, Lansdowne, yeah, sectarian Ireland, I think. Rundown Down, First Bristol, Gainsborough, Gloucester, Aldbourne Chase, First Newbury, Second Hull, Heptonstall, Ripple Field, Winsby, Olney, Basinghouse, Alton, Second Middlewich, Nantwich in Cheshire, right next to the Duke of Westminster's pad, Latham, Newark, Baldon Hill, Cheriton, Selby, many race horses and courses, yeah, in the Peasel crime scene, Lyme Regis, York, where Braveheart was stopped, Lincoln, Bolton, Tipton Green, Cruppredy Bridge, Marston Moor, Ormskirk, Lostwithiel, yeah, romantic kind of Welsh place, Montgomery, Second Newbury, Taunton, all race courses, Jimmy Savile's Scarborough, yeah, Naseby, and there's 5,000 captured, 1,000 killed. This is the first of two. Yeah, Rowton Heath, Torrington, Stow on the Wold, Stephen Andrew Hancock's. Yeah, and all your frauds and all of the asset stripping of every one of those dental students that has to pay way over, in your case, 70 grand for what is a 6-year product. Yeah, Newark, Oxford and Worcester. Yeah, the massive Christian pile that is the cathedral, and Jesus never ever lived, and that's the Piso family's writings. At the beginning of 1645, most of King Charles's advisers urged him to attack the new model army while it was still forming. However, listen to this, Prince Rupert of the Rhine, yeah, Rothschild homeland, who had recently been appointed general of the army and therefore the king's chief military adviser, proposed instead to march north to recover the north of England and join forces with the royalists in Scotland under the Marquis of Montrose. And on it goes. The dates for it are, this is the first one. Oh, I haven't got the whole of the Wikipedia thing. Yeah, do you get it? And there's a second image, and there is the statistics. So this is just Naseby. So you've got parliamentarians versus royalists, Sir Thomas Fairfax and Oliver Cromwell, the massive Freemasons, and the Fairfaxes are built in, are buried in the funeral for the British and the English in Naples, where the Bible was defrauded by the Pisos. Yeah. And that woman has now completely dropped off my Skypey list, unless she's been topped. Yeah. Royalists, Charles I of England, Prince Rupert of the Rhine. Isn't it sickly? And they've got 6,000 horse on one side, yeah, on the parliamentarian horse side, and they've got 4,000 horses on the other side. Yeah, family against family. Yeah, doctrine against doctrine, and Jesus is the person behind driving them along. Never ever lived. Only 1,000 killed in that one battle there. Yeah. So it's pathetic. Let me see the dates. There it is. It's got the image with the knob, and this time the foreskin is off again. Yeah. There it is. And all of the war dead. You've got one of those in front of the heart of Midlothian, yeah, ground that was being asset stripped by the Russian Rothschild, yeah, Romanov Rothschild, yeah, and all of the war dead are on that, but only the officer classes. Right then, so Naseby, oh, the first English Civil War, so that was fought in 1645, and the Holy Wars are still going on. So 1620 to 1650 was the 30 Years' War in Europe. Yeah, and that is Northamptonshire that has all of those foreigners working in the steel yards for all of those massive conflicts in the lead up to World War II. And you can see how having citizens from all countries all around the world absolutely stitches up the integrity and the belief that you should fight for homeland security and should fight for your homeland. It makes the world totally chaotic. Okay, so let me take you through the Morgan story, and then I'll stop and get some sleep. So this is Captain Morgan, and eventually the Pirates of the fucking Caribbean. So the house at Tredegar was bought by the Catholic Church as a convent after it packed up in 1951. Isn't that lovely? Yeah. Later St. Joseph's Roman Catholic Comprehensive School. It was bought by the Newport Corporation in 1974. In December 2011, the National Trust signed an agreement with Newport City Council to take on the management of the building, as well as the 90 acres of gardens and parkland, on a 50-year lease from 2012. I think the Pirates of the Caribbean must be further up, because in the 1950s there would be a major ruckus. Although all of the Lloyd's of London scams and the sinking ships go on right into, yeah, the, oh, right into World War II. I don't know where we missed the massive gulf there. Maybe I've got my computer shut down in the middle of me preparing for this, and maybe I've lost the bit that describes. Oh no, here we go. So John Morgan was created a Knight of the Holy Sepulchre, possibly circa 1448. Okay, that's not 1620. Yeah, that's way into the Christian diaspora, out of Rome and out of all of those places, yeah, east and west into Constantinople and into Ireland. Okay, so later when Henry Tudor was crowned King Henry VII, it was of great benefit to the Morgans of Tredegar, who were great supporters of Henry, and that is one of my favourite novels because it's got the name of my grandpa and my son in it. Yeah, Cry God for Harry. That's about the Tudors beginning to come in, and all the Ructions then were up in the Lancaster region, I think, next to North Wales. But they're right down in the south, next to Barry Island and St. Baruch Obama. St. Baruch is the patron saint of Barry Island. Drowned by God. Swimming across the tiny little pathetic causeway. His elevation to officer of the Tudor crown placed Sir John Morgan's influence and power at a new height. Thomas became Major General, Sir Thomas Morgan, 1st Baronet, 1604, yeah,
16 years ahead of the Holy Wars.
Yeah, served in the Commonwealth forces during the English Civil War, 1642 to 1649. Yeah, so do you see it? That's 1620. We've had 22 years of conflict all over Europe. All the Scottish troops, all the English troops have deployed. That is the Robert Maxwell jokes. It is the Andy Murray jokes, and all of them are warlords. Yeah, it is the Leslies, and I saw the Leslie man, yeah, looking a bit sheepish as he teaches people to drive in this town today. And it's massive, and it's all across Europe. And the Swedes are the biggest killers in that. Yeah? Which is why that man, who's married to the lovely Swedish wife, yeah, who's named Cameron, and who looks just like Marconi that made the radios, comes to mind. They lived in Sweden for a long time. She's a beautiful woman. She works in the NHS, and she worked in Africa, and she knows how rough the divide between rich and poor is. Yeah? So that was 1642 to 1649, was made governor of Gloucester, 1645, yeah, fought in Flanders, yeah, in the 30 years war, Christian versus Christian, and that's Flanders Field, the poppies of the field, yeah, the Christmas speech for the Queen, the popple of the profiteering from the poppies, was wounded in 1661, retired to his estate at Kinnersley in Herefordshire. Okay, and there is my depiction of the 30 years war, and what was happening all around the world at the same time. Okay, it's very difficult to see it because I've just enlarged it from, it's one of the thumbnails for one of my videos. Okay, there's Vesuvius erupting, there is Waterloo nominees. I've still got the Pilgrim Fathers director numbers, yeah, they're registered in York, yeah, and their churches in York are built on stilts because that is the York that floods all the time. Okay, and there's the Hippo Group, the Netherlands, yeah, that's the hippos that are the Piesel horses, and it is intimately linked to the Godfather and the burning of every witch in the world, and everywhere the Christians go, the mountains of fire. That's the Montefiore board members, Michael Ancrum, and the Duchess of Sutherland. Okay, recalled in 1665 to become governor of Jersey. This is just about massacring all the people that live all across the world, and the women and children get raped, and then they get chucked in prison camps if things are not going well on the battlefield. And that is how the Boer War was won, by the English, by chucking the Boer women and children in the death camps, starving them to death, and the crackshots that were their husbands and the Boer militias had to give up, yeah, because they did not want their loved ones yet to be in the shallow graves that are all over our world. Recalled in 1665 to become the governor of Jersey, the tax haven, he died at St. Helier in April 96. Yet this is the Sir John Morgan. So Sir John Morgan followed in his father's profession. Robert Morgan, born circa 1615, became a farmer known as Rimney. And that's the Mitt Romney jokes. He is in the bloodline that owns the whole world and takes you back to the Piesel Bible authors through Versailles and through Queen Elizabeth II, or any of the presidents that you choose to name from Mount Rushmore. Yeah. So, was father of Henry Morgan, who would have a successful career in the Caribbean as a privateer and pirate. Yeah. Yeah, and all of it is massive, and the NATO people that get to be the heads of NATO now are the Sutherlands that are the head of the banking dynasties. I was going to tell you that at the end of yesterday's video. Yeah, Colonel Edward Morgan, born circa 1616, Colonel after 1665, a royalist during the English Civil War, 1649-49, and captain, this is in Asia Blue, yeah, because it must have been something that the gods did, and captain general of the King's forces in South Wales. After the King's arrest and the execution, which you've just seen, he fled to the continent and married Anna Petronilla, the daughter of Baron von Polnitz from Westphalia. Yeah, the German countries, and that is the governor of Lippstadt for Prince Bernhard of the Netherlands. It's in Germany, yeah, and it is still his, and it became in, it was part of the Netherlands for a time, yeah, and they had to give it back, and he made all of the decisions about the reparations, and it's 20 miles east of Dortmund in Germany. They had 6 children, 2 sons and 4 daughters, including Anne Petronella and Joanna. He was appointed Lieutenant Governor of Jamaica. Yeah, the pirates. Yeah, so you've got law enforcers, diplomats, pirates from the same family, and that is the joke about the tax havens now. All of them are tax havens, and the Jamaicans won the sprint. And when they won the sprinting at the Olympics, they got down on one knee, presumably the left knee, I think it was, and they pretended that they were making the Rothschild bow and 5 arrows gesture. Yeah. So this is the Morgans that become the JP Morgans. Yeah. They become the massive people that defraud the banks with the big noses because they pretend that they are banking saviours. Yeah. And they sink the ships that they build for profit, and they sink their presumably disloyal friends. He's the disloyal murderer, yeah, and all of those people that skipped the sinking of the Titanic have the same motives. Look it up on the internet, you'll find, I think there were 7 of them listed. Battle of Naseby, King Charles I visited Tredegar, yeah, that's Charles I that you saw getting his head lopped off with his blood dripping onto the boards. Yeah, that's Jesus's boards. Tapping in the Will Hay films about the windmills being the swastika, and on it goes. Tredegar House in 1645 in 166. During the Civil War, after the battle, he visited Tredegar House in 1645 and had a blether to the Morgans, who were soon to be in the Caribbean, raping and pillaging and slaving. Okay, so 1680, we've got Sir Charles Gould throughout the 18th century, following his father's financial successes, his son further expanded several commercial and industrial projects and virtually established Newport, yeah, as an important trade centre, whilst consolidating their influence on the political and economic issues of the country. They secured a baronetcy in 1859. In 1854, so Waterloo's all over then, Godfrey Morgan fought in and survived the charge of the Light Brigade. Yeah, the massacres, the botched campaigns all over the world, all of the ships that were sunk in the harbour, yeah, at the place that is right next to the Gallipoli crime scene. Yeah, they sink the ships in the harbour, and that place is the name of the place where Prince Diana was killed, in the tunnel, the Lalma tunnel. That means apple, and that was where the harbour was for the ships that were sunk there, knowing that all of the troops would not go back, even the Piso Light Brigade on the back of the horse. Yeah, and that is the one where every time I see the woman who's the dead ringer for the woman who gets her knickers off for Lord Raglan, yeah, she came out and met me 10 days ago. Now, the time telling thing is changing quite dramatically. It used to be within a day or two, 36 hours, But bless you, Belinda, you come out all the time. Yeah, and it's amazing when I asked you, are you involved in intel? She said, absolutely no. Yeah, charge of the Light Brigade at Balaclava. Godfrey was 22 and